It is very interesting to be able to play RARI files in embedded environments. In mobile app development environments, you can play RARI files on iOS and Android through Airbnb's RARI library. However, you cannot use this directly in embedded environments such as ESP32, which are microcontroller-based environments. That's why you can play RARI files as a standalone in embedded environments using a RARI made by Samsung. One thing is that the RARI project is universal for embedded environments. If we use it as a component in ESP IDEA project, you can see many errors. So I'm sharing the RARI component for IDF so that it can be easily used in IDF environments. So you can easily use LVGS RARI prior using this. So in this video, I will show you how to use ESP RARI. The screen that I will show you from now on creates an empty project and shows how to play a RARI file on the screen through LVGL. If we are already ready to use LVGL in an IDF environment, skip the first part and start from the part where you install the ESP RARI component. The device used here is ESP32S3 Box 3, one of the Aspersive's official devices. It supports the BSP component they provide, so you can start an LVGL project right away without an extra settings. Since we all have different types of displays, ESP32 boards, it is impossible to make one video that covers them all. That's why I recommend that you first prepare LVGL to work in IDF environment before starting this project. Then you can try RARI Player right away. This is the device setup I have. I will skip over this part quickly. If you have the same device as me, you may want to refer to this. I'd like you to just skip this part because your device is different. Again, depending on the device and display you have, the display driver is different, so you need to prepare your device settings for yourself. I will create a components folder and put LVGL and ESP LVGL port in it. The reason is that I need to modify the two components a little bit, but managed components do not allow any modifications. I will move ESP LVGL port to the component folder, and I will remove LVGL and download the latest version from GitHub again. If you look at the CMake list of ESP LVGL port, there's a part that automatically selects LVGL 9 or LVGL 8 depending on the installed LVGL version. Since the IDF components.yaml file is not working properly, I need to set this part to LVGL 9. Let's set up the necessary parts in SDK config. I need to do some basic device settings. Scrolling down, a flash is 60 megabytes. Partition changes to large partition because we need to add a RARI file later. Continue scrolling down. Set PSRAM, set it to octal mode because this device has this type of PSRAM. Go to LVGL settings. Change the size of LVMLog to 128 kilobytes. There is a RARI library below, but it is not available for now, so I will set it up later. Let me create a very simple LVGL screen to check that everything I have set up so far is working properly. This is just creating a label, so I will go through it very quickly. As you can see, a label has been created that prints the current AirVisual version on the screen. Let's check if this is displayed properly on the device. Here we are. You can see my device, which is currently displaying the AirVisual version on the screen. I like this kind of checkpoint because it allows for early resolution of issues. Now you can use ESP Alerty component from here. If AirVisual is not working, you cannot do anything, so please make sure to check this first. This contains all the settings to work in the ESP IDF environment, so you can easily use it in your project. The next setting is ESP CMake settings for AirVisual. We need to add ESP Alerty here to use AirVisual's Alerty Player functions. Go to SDK config again. Finally, enable AirVisual's Alerty library. After getting the Alerty animation file, it's time to test the system we have built so far. If you visit alertyfiles.com, you can download a lot of Alerty animation files. Most of the animations I showed in the intro are from here. Let me show you how to use it. I've covered this in detail in the one of previous videos, so I will just show you briefly. After downloading and opening the file, you will see data in JSON format. Since this cannot be directly pressed in a char array, it is converted to an escape JSON string and used. Let me make a header file to contain this data. Create an array of const type and put the converted data in it. This completes the preparation of the Alerty animation file. After including this file, finally, you can read the file through AirVisual's Alerty create from raw function. That's it. Let's see the result. Congratulations! You can finally play the Alerty animation on your ESP32 device. As I showed, there are a few things that need to be fixed in order to use this. I hope this will be fixed in a future update. I also hope to share my new projects that utilize this component. That's it. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.